straight to the chick as soon as I hop up. Blood got scripts, it's only to hit the dock up. Cream of wheat package, you cook it and watch it rock up. One up top, Aki, it's one of them not to rock.
I took a lot, Joe.
My nigga don't put the rock up. You ain't got a chance at the league if niggas locked up.
But you're sweetest, sweetest Princess Silka.
When you face an attempted hours, huh? We're all them niggas you call your brother now. Ain't none of them niggas gon' hold your mother down. It's highly respected when you don't make a sound. Field trip to the necklace, you ever fuck around. Dumb it down is what my nana told me. These niggas playing like they ain't knowing what this nana hold, and it's loaded. Gangland and I'm standing on it. How I die behind mines, I've been planning on it. Yeah, we with the pop up, specialize in walk ups. They gon' need some hoodies created, who do the mock up? Yoppa with the new shields in it, so we don't lock up. Yoppa with the new shields in it, so we don't lock up. We with the pop up, specialize in walk ups. They gon' need some hoodies created, who do the mock up? Yoppa with the new shields in it, so.
Here I am, your super soft, silky smooth, Principessa Silkita. Always sweet, very intelligent, super generous, sharing myself and my wisdom with you here in my Atacolacho and outside when you engage, of course. Then you can see it. So, yeah, he was destined. Definitely, yes. I know my stories are always the same, although I might get more insight. I might have wisdom to depict things from a different angle. Because I'm just reading it like a movie. I'm reading the story, I'm looking into it. Moments, experiences, happenings. Like a movie. And I'm recounting what I see in the movie. So you might have different camera shots, but it is the same movie. Why? Because people invent stuff. Narcissists invent stuff. Because they're traumatized. My stepmother invented plenty. In projection. She blamed me for all her misdeeming, horrible things she did to me. And yeah, he wanted to do that too. But I stopped him. I didn't allow him. And that is the issue with Yaki for many years. Let's go back to the issue. One issue after the other was named. And the issue right now in the beginning was the alcoholism. Okay. No, I have to listen to mine. How would you like me to tell the story? I can go now anywhere you want. No, I didn't tell you the entire scene. I have not described the entire scene from the beginning. You want me to? Okay, let's do that then. Yaiki had made an issue not to wash his hair. He told me later. He had a hat, a beanie hat. And it was disgusting. That I saw later. Because, I don't know, maybe it was smelly, but it was like... So I wanted to wash it and he said no. And he made a joke with the shower. He had a shower and a bathtub, by the way. That was some heavy metal thing, I think. Yeah, I don't know, that was weird. Whatever that was, one of those attachments. And his type of hair didn't really help. It was very, you know, it wasn't really good. But he combed it to the back and it was a little long. I like that. And men. Yes. There is a style to it. I like it. Just a little bit, you know. No, when you see cool haircuts and the reels, that's exactly what I think. I don't know how it's named. No, never mind. Let's not go there. Oh, say that again. I noticed I wasn't swallowing that much yesterday in my Atacolacho. Because now I'm not drinking tea. I'm drinking water. And the tea doesn't really take the thirst away, as I have acknowledged when I was with Caududo, sitting on that dining table. Yeah, and Dame Liliana, his wife, ex-wife then. What a contrast, that freaking nutty Liliana. No, she was pretty. Well, you disagree. Fine, good. Aura and I. Yeah, for Liliana he was way too large, but for me he was too small, Caududo. But we're talking about Yaiki right now, how about... We can go back and talk about Caududo again, what a surprise. I was not expecting the Kaduru story. That was a new one. Yeah, because how can you find it? Hundreds and thousands of Aitakalachos. Where did she talk about Kaduro? Let's just talk again. Let's move on. Whatever you want. Well, I'm crying again. I was crying. See, this is the thing. Right now, here I say it. I don't know if there's new people coming into the Aitakalacho. Or I don't know if you're just bored and want to listen again. Or I don't know, it's just the soothing of my voice. Yeah, I don't go there. Dumb pianist I talked about. He wanted to listen to my voice to do himself a favor. How about that? People used to tell me in Mexico on the phone, wow, tienes voz de locutora. You've got voice of a... That is a weird notion. Anchorman? That's a dumb title. Oh, that is a tab I have opened from the previous video. Layover. Yeah, yesterday I was given in the field overlay and it didn't sound it exactly right. But I don't use words which I don't understand. And that is another tab I will have open today. What is this and what is that? I will come back to it. I'm not gonna open it right now. I have it on my note list, so I will not forget. If I look at the German word for layover, I can find that word layover. If I look at the Spanish word for layover, Google Translate gives me plenty, but not that word layover. See how translation is not that simple. So I had a layover in Frankfurt. What, down from me, who? Green. And that's not all. I heard that he had seen me before. In the field or with Maitreya. I don't know when that came to me. That was absolutely with Maitreya. I think it was before exhibition, but then again, I'm not 100% sure. Because I don't give a damn. He saw me playing. Really, you want to deviate from that subject? We can go back on... Somehow I like order, okay? I like order in my stories. Because there's so much to say. Encompassing the green story. It doesn't really mix with the encompassing Yaki story. Because there's more to say. He had seen me before in a concert I was playing. My saxophone. It was a Christian festival. South of Hamburg. It doesn't matter to us. We're playing Christian festivals. And that he was there. Wow, he had seen me in Dortmund. That was the first time. And that was... Woo. How interesting. Okay, let's go there another time. Yeah, derailed, I think. Following me around the world. So years on end without saying something. Man. That seems like flagellation. Yeah, self-mutilation. I cannot emphasize on that. Let's go back to Yaiki, unless you want me to continue now with this story. You want it all? Well, I can think about both stories at the same time, but I cannot say it. I cannot talk both stories. What is interesting is that I analyze things. And now you get things too. Now I'm yawning. I'm getting bored. I'm not asked. See, someone has to ask me to say it. Why would I get bored telling? What is the issue? The issue is always to give you confidence and trust that you allow yourself to feel into your intuition and that you get to know who you are with if you would like to continue and further yourself on. That is the issue. Every time. And that includes a lot of the things which I'm showing in my Aitakalacho in the stories. I'm gonna have a sip of coffee now. Okay. I came to the conclusion that first impressions are always right, but also that my intuition is always right. I noticed I just had an accent with the also, because my tongue was kind of hot. I'm hot. Okay, let's move on. See what I mean? I'm innocent because I'm pure. I only have pure intentions. I wasn't expecting Yankee to become anything of me as I met him in Mexico. It was quite impressive how he called me and called me and called me. Okay, let's move on. How did I met him? So he called me that next day. No, I'm not going to repeat what I said in the previous video. So he called me at 11 a.m. to ask me if I would accompany him for dinner in his last evening in Mexico. Later he told me that he had been up since, I don't know, 8 o'clock, thinking he wanted to call me, running around, you know, back and forth, not knowing exactly which would be the best time to call me. And he waited until that time. I don't know. I picked him up at the evening. He said on the phone, well, the only thing is, it's not really a condition, but something like that. Yeah, please accompany me for dinner, but please tell me where to go because I don't know any place in Cuernavaca. So I had a place in mind, and that is the story. We went to this place, and he ordered a bottle of champagne. And I felt honored. It was a marriage proposal. I felt honored. I felt it. Who orders champagne? It was, see, I never went to any club. It was not some asshole move, some nigger who orders, they don't, what do they order again? They don't order with Clicquot, they order that other thing. What is that again? I have to think about it, I don't know. Whatever name that is, anybody told them it's fine because it's very expensive. So they order that for the girls and their friends to presume. Yaki wasn't presumptuous. He honored my presence. He wanted to give me the best. So he ordered a bottle of champagne. Yeah, I call it champagne. You know what I mean, right? Bubbly, but it doesn't sound good. Let's just keep it champagne, although we know it's not champagne. Or maybe it was. I don't know. Could I care less? In restaurants like that, you only have one type, usually. Unless you go to a really fancy one. And that is the story. I did not invite him to a fancy restaurant. There is one fine dining in Cuernavaca. That is the place you get marriage proposals. That is the place you celebrate anniversaries. That is the place. It's called Las Mañanitas, and you got tablecloths, and you got, you know, fine dining. Beautiful gardens too, it's impressive. A little bit old-fashioned, but it's not obnoxious, it's good. And then there's a little waiting area, which is a bar. You don't have to stand in the restaurant waiting for your table ever. They are very comfortable seats, separate from the restaurant. You can also just sit there and have a drink. I did not brought him to that place. I trusted and followed my intuition because he said if I could accompany him for dining, for dinner. He didn't said show me Cuernavaca. He didn't want to explore Cuernavaca because if he would have said that, then I would have brought him to Las Mañanitas. He wanted to explore me. I felt it the way he said it. Yeah, in English, of course. He does not speak Spanish. No, he never did. So, me, that's a different subject. I am not abusive. No, he could have afforded that, but I wasn't thinking about affording or not affording. Okay, so I brought a dummy to Las Mañanitas. I liked her. I liked the couple. It was a couple from... I liked her. She was like maternal in a way. He too, paternal in a way. They were nice to me. And she was direct and straightforward in many ways. So she asked me, my brother is coming to town. Could you take him for lunch? Yeah, because he's lonely. I had no clue that he had other intents. Why not? I do that. I'm PR. I'm the director of, and I do that, and I have to. And she was a friend, so of course. So he was lonely. He comes to visit. So I wasn't thinking me, I was thinking, well, someone has to. So I brought him to Las Mañanitas. Maybe I told her. Because it's the best. So he can explore Cuernavaca. That is the best of Cuernavaca. No, he's on a visit. No, he was a complete asshole, an idiot, some knuckle, some like Tom Hanks in Forrest Gump, almost. Yeah, I went to dinner with Forrest Gump. No, but sorry, it was lunch. It was the middle of the day. I had no clue that she had other intents after years later. She was completely idiota, if you think about it. Years later, she came to visit me as she saw, you know, now I had children. She came, I invited her with her husband, and then I hear her saying over here to her husband, wow, that could have been, I don't know what's the name of her brother. That could have been his children. And her husband shut it off. Alma, he said, like, what? How dare you to say this in her house and in front of her? No, he had style in a way. That's when I noticed that she wanted to verkuppeln, that she wanted to hook me up with him. She's stupid. Principessa Silkita with Forrest Gump, are you joking? So anyhow, I brought him there and it was totally stupid. But I eat, I'm silent, and if he says something, I listened. I don't think he said anything. On a higher purpose, there was a different purpose to it. But that's a different story. Someone else, the lightest story, he's told me there, but that let's not go there. So Jackie wanted to explore me. And I had seen this place. No, I had no doubt. There was immediately, I knew where to go. I don't remember the name right now. Immediately, I knew where to go because I had been there 3 months before, once. And that is the story. In October 15th, I gave my largest concert in Cuernavaca. And I'm tired. And at the end of that concert, some people proposed to go have a drink. Yeah, my fans. My fans. So we were standing in front of the concert hall and pondering where to go, but I don't participate in the opinion making. So someone proposed, so we went to that place. Which is interesting because sometime later, I received a complaint from Cece and Jeffrey, from Jeffrey Peters, the American couple, the guy who gave me the flowers in one of the other concerts. I received a loud complaint. He was actually loud and complaining to me that I had left him sitting, him or them, sitting in Marco Polo, which is the Italian pizza place in front, right in front of the rest of the concert hall. I left him sitting there, that I was supposed to go there to celebrate my concert. I looked at him, what? I had no clue. I had no memory whatsoever that anybody proposed we should go to Marco Polo. And that they were waiting there, I had no idea. Because I don't leave people sitting. I don't do these kind of things. If I would have known that he and his wife, Jeffrey Peters, he said that he was working with the president to become in the United States, but that he did not want the elections under Bush because Bush was duping the elections, just like Salinas de Gortari had done. That Bush never won the elections, but they're, you know, they messed with the polls, or however you call that. Fraud. And that he stopped being in politics and then he moved to Mexico with his wife. Yeah, the couple. So I don't leave people sitting or standing. If I would have known that they are waiting now in Marco Polo and someone else proposed a different place, I would have sent someone over because it was right in front. Go tell them that we go to a different place. Anyhow, we went to this place someone proposed. And that was so pretty. It was informal and dark with plenty of candles and like patio style in a way. So Cuernavaca. So lush and warm climate. I liked it so very much. Now here I was sitting in that place. Lamentable, Pavarotti was there, and his mother, and his father, and his brother, and I don't know, and so many people, and yeah, I remember, but there were like 20 or 30 people sitting. Get it? Now I was babe. Now I was famous to become. It was the initiation of an oval lunch of a new era of arse-licking. Having 20 or 30 people sitting next to me after my concert. A new era of arse-licking me. That's what it was. Yet luckily, I escaped Mexico. I stepped out of the country, so I never lived that. Why? Because... No, I was the star. Remember the massive attack? Now, who is Honey? I was Honey. I was Babe. Remember? I had the mic. That's a cool song. Massive attack. Five-man army. Who's got the mic now? Now who is Honey? Now who is Honey? I was Honey. Now I'm laughing my ass off. That's what it is. Because pinche Jesus and Erika, men, freaking assholes. I wasn't allowed to sing at their wedding. Why? That was mean, the way they put it. After so many years of friendship, I offered. No, I had to recapitulate because everyone else would have looked like an arsehole next to me. So they didn't want it to, I don't know. But it was kind of mean. Now they come. And now they're there. Why not? doesn't matter. I forgive. Anyhow, so I was sitting there, and unfortunately I was sitting next to Pavarotti, whom I left. Not the next day, because next day was Sunday, but on the Monday. A few days earlier than I thought, because I couldn't handle anymore. Yeah, I moved out just 2 days later. And the energy was so, so bad. Oh, the tenor, he wasn't there. I don't think so. So the tenor, he told me, wow, Zilka, your energy is so bad. Well, yeah, because I was out of my mind, man. I was just about to get another rash or maybe another scar. Oh, I will talk about my scars too, if you want. Yeah, of course you do. It's on my list. I couldn't handle it. And I gave the concert with all that pressure. Yeah, nervous breakdown next to that dumb art narcissist, Pavarotti. And this idiot mother, who of course came to bother me too in front of the, you know, in the beginning of the concert. In the dressing room, man, she came just, she always imposing every time to disturb my energy. I did not want them next to me, but here they were sitting. I'm silent with all the people in that restaurant. Now everyone had like one drink and then we left. It was weird because I may be the star, but I'm not like, I can be the soul of the party, but it was not the ambiance to do that, so I'm silent. Oh, you wanted me to do that? At the concert, oh, the tenor. No, he wasn't, I don't think he was there, because I would have noticed him, and I don't remember him sitting next to me. I think the tenor left right after the concert and took the pianist with him, because the tenor had a car and the pianist was just visiting the country. Back to the city, Mexico City. In the concert, we sang that duo. And at the end, people wanted more and more and more. I think I gave an encore. But then I asked them what they wanted. That was me engaging with the public. Maybe I had to do it. I could have just sang another encore. I could have just sang any aria. That was no issue. I have plenty. But I asked them what they wanted, my audience. Maybe just so they could see I'm very simple. So they all wanted that love duo. So we did that love duo again. And later I understood I should not have done that love duo without the aria to begin with. They didn't know it was two pieces. The solo aria of Mimi. And then the duo. I considered that later. Someone must have told me in the field, or I don't know. So no, I didn't like the tenor. He was an arsenal. I'm so generous. He was a real asshole. Let's move on. So I was sitting in that restaurant now with my 20 or 30 fans, or newly to become fans. And they all felt small. The entire row felt small to me. All little tiny arsenals. Just in the feeling, I don't even know who was there. Besides whom I just mentioned. Don't remember. Yeah, a bro of arslickers to become. See what I mean? I was honey. Now I was honey. Not before. See, I'm laughing myself. But I thought, this place is so pretty. I'd like to come here again, I said. In my heart, in my head. That's so pretty. It would be nice to have a dinner here. And when Yaiki came and asked me where to go, I knew immediately where to go.
She's born.